Hi friends, this is Pustha from Vyans Medical Academy. Today I am here to discuss about breathing and exchange of gases. Friends, have you ever wondered how do we breathe? Why do we consider breathing as a crucial life process? What is breathing? The exchange of oxygen from the atmosphere and release of carbon dioxide from our produced by the cells is known as breathing, which is also termed as respiration. In this chapter, I am going to discuss about the respiratory organs, mechanism of breathing, volumes and capacities, exchange of transport of gases, regulation and the disorders. Yeah friends, as we well know that our respiratory organs, first I am going to discuss about, starts with nose, leads to nasal cavity. Nasal cavity leads to nasopharynx, which is also known as common passage for food and air. Nasopharynx leads into larynx, which is also known as sound box. In birds, it is also known as syrinx. Larynx leads to trachea. The fifth thoracic vertebrae, trachea divides into right and left bronchi. This bronchi leads to primary bronchioles, secondary bronchioles and terminal bronchioles. Bronchiole leads to alveoli. These bronchi, bronchioles and alveoli located in the lung region, as we well know, lungs are plays a crucial role in our respiratory system. This is the visceral organ which is filled with pleura membrane. The pleura membrane which is filled with pleura fluid, which reduces the friction on the surface. It is a very sensitive part of our body. Lung is a very sensitive part of our body, which can't able to direct altered that pulmonary volume. With the help of thoracic chamber, the lungs used to change this volume. The thoracic chamber is covered by dorsally by the vertebral column, ventrally by the sternum, laterally by the ribs, and lower side the dome-shaped diaphragm. Next, the topic is mechanism of breathing. In the breathing mechanism, it includes inspiration and expiration. The air which we breathe in is known as inspiration. The air which we breathe out is known as expiration. Means, inspiration is initiated by the contraction of diaphragm and increase in the volume of thoracic chamber. If thoracic chamber volume increases, pulmonary volume also increases. Expiration, the air which we breathe out is known as expiration. It is initiated by the relaxation of diaphragm and decrease in the volume of thoracic chamber. Thoracic chamber volume decreases, our lung capacity also decreases. That's the mechanism of breathing. Next, very important topic from this chapter is volumes and capacities. First of all, residual volume, RV. The volume of air inspired or expired during normal expiration is known as residual capacity. Tidal volume. The volume of air inspired or expired during normal breathing is known as tidal volume. Next, inspiratory reserve volume. The volume of air inspired during forcible inspiration is known as inspiratory reserve volume, ERV. Expiratory reserve volume. The volume of air expired during forcible expiration is known as ERV. The total volume of air remains in the lungs after forcible expiration is known as residual volume. We can get the lung capacities, IC. IC means the volume of air inspired during normal expiration is known as IC. By adding TV and IRV, we get IC. Next, expiratory capacity. The volume of air expired during normal inspiration is known as EC. By adding ERV and TV, we get EC. Next, functional residual volume. Volume of air inspired during normal expiration is known as functional residual volume. By adding RV and ERV, we get functional residual volume. Next, vital capacity. The volume of air remain in the lungs even after forcible expiration and inspiration is known as vital capacity. TLC. The volume of air remains in the lungs even after forcible inspiration is known as TLC. Friends, these capacities and volumes are measured by an instrument known as spirometer, but TLC and FRC can't be measured with that instrument. Please remember that. Next, we will enter into the topic exchange and transport of gases. As you well know, the part of alveoli which is present in the lungs play a major role in the exchange part, which is also known as primary part of exchange of gases. This alveolar membrane is covered by three layers, which is thin squamous epithelium, endothelium and a basement membrane. Next, transport of gases. Blood plays a major role in the transport of gases. First of all, O2 by RB, through RBC, O2 carries 97%, through plasma it carries 3%. By RBC, 20 to 25% of CO2 is carries. Next, through plasma, 7% of CO2 is carries. Through bicarbonate, 70% of CO2 is transported in the blood. Next, the topic is regulation. We the human beings have a capacity to regulate our respiratory organs. Are maintained by the respiratory rhythm center, which is present in the medullary region of the brain, and the pneumotoxic center, which is present in the pons region of the brain, and at last the chemosensitive area, which is present in the medullary region, can alter the respiratory volume. And the last and final topic of this chapter is disorders. Disorders caused by respiratory organs are asthma. Asthma means the inflammation, it is difficulty in breathing due to the inflammation of bronchi and bronchioles is known as asthma. Emphysema, it is a chronic disorder which is caused by the people who are addicted for cigarette smoking. Next, some of the occupational disorders will be seen in the people who works in industries, mines and quarries. Example, silicosis, this disease is caused by people who works in silicon industries. Asbestosis, this disease is caused by people who works in the cement and asbestosis industries. Class, the black lung disease, it is seen in the people who works in the coal mines. That's the end of the chapter. Please don't neglect this chapter. From these disorders only, in 2018 they asked 2 bits. From this volume they asked 1 bit in 2018. So please don't neglect this chapter. Finally, VN Medical Academy wishes you a good luck for your NEET 2019. Thank you.